brand new episode of Truth Unveiled. Like our last episode, we are going to unveil a truth today. The true colors of our educationalist. Who are the sole responsibility people to lay foundation to our children's future? Here we have Mrs. Meherniza Khan, IAS, Secretary General of Educational Department, Kerala. Madam, could you please explain to our viewers the main intention of the education and our government's mission on that?
Hello. To start with the intention of our education, I would like to say the government is intending comprehensive educational reforms, including all the government schools into international standards. The idea is not only to improve the infrastructural facilities, but also to reform the teaching and learning process to the present day needs. There will be focus on creating educational programs which are useful for all students. It is also meant to reinforce the teaching and learning process by providing ample opportunities to each student to construct their own knowledge using modern technology tools.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for sharing your valuable time with us.
Now, let us talk to a Kerala government school teacher about the education system of our state government.
Hello, ma'am. We are from Truth Unveiled program. We are doing a study on our educational system today. Could you please give us a moment and answer a few questions for us?
Yes, of course. I am happy to be of help.
I'm sure that you are aware of the Kerala government's agenda on education. How do you, as a teacher, contribute towards that mission?
I have reached this position in this job after a lot of struggling and hard work. To get a job in government school is hardest of all the jobs in Kerala. And I made it happen with my never-ending efforts. Government schools are a place where students from any phase of the society are welcomed and they are all treated equal. All the staff are entitled to follow the missions of government to achieve the goals of education, to keep Kerala always on the top chart, to educate children, to become the future of our country, to make them a better social being, and to educate them enough to become able leaders of our nation. And that is how we mold our kids in our school, to bring out the best citizens of our nation. That is how we have planned and arranged our curriculum.
How sincere do you think you're doing your job?
Well, we do not just blindly follow the textbooks. We explore different study materials so that the child gets different aspects of the topic, and practical workshops are given to on-time completion of the syllabus and giving them time to revision the subjects before exams, doing class tests and exercises in order to make them more confident before they appear for their exams, and other curricular activities are always encouraged, like opportunities for making them good at sports, and occasional recreational trips help us to bond a very good student-teacher relationship.
There is a general ideology. All government students are not much appreciated by other private schools. People always look down to the government school kids. What you have to tell about that towards us?
Not at all. That is complete absurd. And this might be the case when you talk about 20 to 30 years back, but nowadays people are educated enough to understand the value of government schools. And such mentality of people are sad. And it's not true as far as I believe.
So final question, madam. Where do your kids go to school?
My children go to the best ICSE school in the whole state, the Frost Marion Elementary School. You know, their system is the best. They have a very good syllabus. They work with the children to bring out their hidden talents in each student. And they spend time with the students to mold their characters and intelligence.
Those are the same efforts expected from you towards the government school kids. Why do you send your kids to the private school instead of admitting them on your school itself?
Sorry, I have class children now. Sorry.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Good morning.
Good morning, teacher.
Sit down. all are present today?
Yes!
Hey, Rahma, you there?
Yeah.
Take a look. This is very interesting.
Huh, I have watched this in my phone.
This is how much most of our government school teachers are committed towards the future of our students. Now, let us take you to a private school and talk a teacher over there. Madam, could you please tell us the school system in teaching?
Yeah, of course. I'm happy to share our school system with you. We are more into creative learning rather than traditional learning. We have various methods where we show any object, for example, a flower, to the kids. We then teach them how to pronounce the word flower. We explain them the syllables and we train them to spell the word by themselves. We make sure the students try themselves to spell the word and understand the sounds of the word about of the object, here a flower, by touching and feeling them. Unlike in normal school, how they force the kids to write multiple times on a paper. This is an example I put here now. We have cultivated the system through a very effective child-centered activities in which students are exposed to all practical approaches of learning. Not many schools concentrate on overall development of the students as much as our school does. All our staffs are very keen in supporting their students in their emotional strength.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning. Sit down. How are you? Today we are going to learn a new word. FLOWER. Take your notebooks and write this 50 times. Hey, you loser! Why not copy? Write this down 100 times tomorrow and show me.
Now, you did witness the hypocrisy of our educational system and, moreover, our educationalists. Who has the genuine concern about the future of our students? Do you believe our future citizens are given good education as they deserve by these people? They should try and act to their consciences to stay truthful towards their profession.